The novena in honor of St. Thorlak of Iceland. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the holy life and example of St. Thorlak of Iceland. Inspired at the youngest age to seek wisdom, he found it in you, in the Psalms and writings of Holy Scripture, in the virtuous instruction of the priests who fostered him, and in the majestic natural wonders of his homeland. Receiving holy orders at 18, Thorlak devoted his entire life to feeding the spiritual and material hunger of his people. His quiet compassion for the poor and suffering led him to long hours of prayer on their behalf. He afforded peasants and penitents the same dignity he showed chieftains and kings. May St. Thorlak help us live and to love according to your will. Amen. St. Thorlak, quietly humble and pure of heart, pray for us. St. Thorlak, mentor in wisdom, pray for us. St. Thorlak, gentle pastor, pray for us. St. Thorlak, merciful confessor, pray for us. St. Thorlak, champion of families and holy matrimony, pray for us. St. Thorlak, defender of authentic Catholic living in all states of life, pray for us. St. Thorlak, fatherly intercessor, pray for us. St. Thorlak, true ambassador for Christ, pray for us. St. Thorlak, devoted patron of Iceland, pray for us. Heavenly Father, we pray that all people in Iceland may be united in Christ under the patronage of your holy servant, St. Thorlak. May all taste your unending love and mercy and rejoice in your presence. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Novena in honor of St. Thorlak of Iceland, Day 8. St. Thorlak, true ambassador for Christ. St. Thorlak often acted as mediator between feuding parties, between chieftains and the church, and between penitents and God. It may be said that he took the role of ambassador in these matters, since in each case he was acting as a diplomat for Jesus Christ and his kingdom. Thorlak may have been quiet and humble, but he never flinched in his duties as ambassador for Christ to chieftains, archbishops, and kings, even more to ordinary people. St. Thorlak was no stranger to political tension. When elected Bishop of Skalholt, he validly received this office from his predecessor. However, formal consecration could only be conferred by the Archbishop of Norway, who in turn required consent from the king. The political hostilities between Iceland and Norway at the time found the king unwilling to consent, even threatening violence against Iceland. St. Thorlak held steadfast to his request, asking nothing more than acceptance and validation of his election. Eventually, his quiet perseverance won out, and the king's blessing was given. St. Thorlak was as much a diplomat between the church and its people. He ranked highly as bishop, yet preferred the company of common folk. He held himself to high personal standards of fasting and abstinence, but if, for instance, he attended a banquet where alcohol was served, he gave the gracious appearance of sipping his drink in appreciation, but secretly never truly imbibed. In another example of his magnanimity, it was revealed at St. Thorlak's funeral that he had quietly cared for a man with leprosy until his death. Such was the way of Bishop Thorlak, faithful representative of Jesus to all he met. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, help us to remember that as Christians we are called to be ambassadors of your kingdom among our own friends, families, and municipalities. Help us to emulate the example of St. Thorlak in always remembering our allegiance as your representatives. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.